Hello, my name's Henry L. Jones. My poem, Thunder Lives Here, Chicago Life in the Hole, is what I'm about to recite. Another Chicago evening, glaring lights and loud cars. Street lights cast stray silhouettes, flickering wildly on my walls. Shadows of outside world. Below my window, I hear hot tongues shouting, dropping many F-bombs aimed at the pavement cracks to break your mama's back. No mushroom cloud scene, blinding radioactive bursts, or winds of hell release, just loud, angry screams. Then there was a silence, a hush deafening the whole. Even my heart seemed to stop beating and waited for sound as proof I am still alive. I peeked outside my window where people stood, many angry eyes stared, no one said anything, while sweat trickled down frowning foreheads, open nose hairs and holes flared, close enough to smell brewed funk from the long day on this hot August night. Then a voice asked, "You want some of me? You want some of me? You want some of me?" Then I heard what sounded like thunder cracking in the sky and sat back on my bed. I saw no rain falling or smelled any coming as a gentle trickle or heavy shower to wet and wash away corner to corner piled trash left overflowing and stinking but rarely removed by weekly sweeping of curbs cleaned along each block. Instead, more echoed thunder sang from heaven within the pitch of night, making my window blinds rattle from scented breezes smelling like fireworks exploded on the 4th of July to remember the smiles of that holiday to comfort us with twisted lies about our freedom. Firecrackers popped off again, clouds singing bass booms, caroling along attentive buildings. My window's glass rattled, then stopped with a lengthy pause. I looked into the streets outside but saw no rain, or puddles pooled in broken craters of loose tar in the road, where tomorrow morning children could jump into them to splash water into the air, sprinkling like beautiful fountains, landing onto the sidewalks where awaiting pigeons wish to play and drink. Instead, what I saw was a pool of blood where a man's head full of bullet holes appeared to float like a beach ball. That thunder of hatred only brought a drizzle of death, leaving a corpse, baptized for the love and blessing of a God who needed a sacrifice with this mortal's discounted life, marked and weighed by the Reaper, who placed the man's drenched skull onto his lap and wiped the blood away from his face. Then he looked up at me and smiled, then said to me with fingers pointing like a gun, "Bang, bang."